Welcome guys for the presentation of schema refinement. Schema, you must understand the meaning of this. It is a logical structure of database. Most of the databases normally contains the structure in the tabular format, indicates it rows and column form. So this is the schema normally used. Actually, in fact, we can be used a conceptual database design. In the conceptual database design, after completion of the conceptual database design, it gives us a set of relation schemas and some integrity constraints. So the relation indicated in the form of this structure, tabular structure. So this relation contains some data as well as integrity constraints, and the structure of relation schema, as we all know, it contains in the form of a tabular. Tabular form might contains different information or different data in this table. So this table might be contains sometimes redundant data. So that is here we need to be mentioned importantly. So what is the meaning of redundant here? This table may contains the data which have some duplication of fields. So it might be leads to the some different kind of problems. So the duplication of data exists in the database. We need to be taking care of that. Otherwise, it leads to the different kind of problems. So what type of redundancy normally exists in the relations? Basically, there is a row level redundancy may exist. Row indicates this. Sometimes a column level redundancy also possible. The column indicates this. These are all columns. This also possible redundancy. So basically, this is the important concept or reason for this discussion of schema refinement. You need to refine the schema because that schema contains this redundancy. Let us see what are the different types of problems if there is a redundancy. So basically, we might mention there are kind of problems here: insertion anomaly, deletion anomaly, and update anomaly. Here anomaly indicates there is some difficulty or a problem or a constraint. In any relational database, we need to be perform operation of insertion, deletion, updation is quite common. If your database contains a redundancy, so then definitely we need to look at in this insertion, deletion, and updation problems. So how to resolve these things? Before that, we must understand what exactly insert anomaly, delete anomaly, and update anomaly. Let us look at with an example in this case of insertion anomaly. Suppose, for example, in the insertion anomaly, may not possible to store certain information unless some other need to be inserted. Unrelated information is need to be stored as well. Let us look at, we need to be insert some information and forced to insert some other information also. So that is the basic problem in the insertion anomaly. Let us see with this example of this table. In this table contains student ID, student name, and student join in the course of course, that is course ID and course name. So the student number 10 is the name of the student is Raju, joined in the course of C1. ID is C1 and his name of the course is this one. So at present, this institution, for example, this is the database maintained by the institution. For example, I have two courses in this C1 and C2. I introduced the new course, which is called C3. I am going to be talk about this C3 is a new course. For example, let us see here, I need to be insert a new course C3, which is called, for example, Python. So I need to be insert a new row here to insert. So what is the courses? I newly introduced the course, which is called C3, and course name is called Python. I am going to be introduced. So, but I must be insert because students so far not yet joined, but only this course is introduced. So I forced to insert some information into these two fields also. Like similarly, I introduced course 4, which is, for example, called as R programming. Then I supposed to be insert, forcefully to insert these two fields also. So this is indicated here is insert anomaly. So let us look at once again this definition or this point. May not possible to store certain information. Look at here, may not possible to store certain information. This may not be possible to store this information unless some other unrelated information is stored as well. Here this is unrelated information I need to be stored. This is unrelated. This is the information I have to be stored, but this unrelated information I have to be stored, this kind of problem is called as insertion anomaly. I think you are clear now according to this example. So that is the meaning of insertion of some data, forced to insert unexisting data. This is unexisting data. This is insertion anomaly. Let us go to the second anomaly, second problem, which is called as delete anomaly. So which is called as delete anomaly. So in this case of delete anomaly, it may not possible to delete certain data without losing some other data, some unrelated data as well. So look at here in this example. At present, I am going to be delete the C++ course because which is not presently teaching in this institute. So I need to be eliminate this course from my institution. So if I need to be eliminate this course, I need to be delete this course C1 and C++, but forced to delete this information also, which is important for me, but I have to be delete this information also. So because of deletion of some data, forced to lose other data. If I delete these two things, two CID and CNAME from this table, I forced to delete this information also, which is necessary for us. This information is necessary for us, but I have to be deleted because these corresponding things are going to be deleted. So this is called delete anomaly. So your schema may sometimes this kind of problems, this anomaly, this is called delete anomaly. Once again, in this delete anomaly, we are trying to delete a data. We need to be delete other related data also. Let us go for another anomaly, another problem here, which is called as update anomaly. So this case of update anomaly, in one copy of such repeated data is updated, an inconsistency, this is the important here, inconsistency is created unless all copies are similarly updated. Repeat again, in one copy of such repeated data is updated. Look at here, I am trying to be updated here the data, repeated data. An inconsistency is created unless all copies are similarly updated. For example, I updated here, instead of C1 in my institution, I changed this course code earlier C1 C++. Now I changed this C1 is, for example, Python, because C++ is I am trying to eliminate. So I need to be changed here. I need to be update here. Now C1 is updating here Python. So if I changed here C1 Python, But look at, I need to be update everywhere. See, C1, C++, but here C1, Python. This indicated as inconsistency. Inconsistency leads here, like if it contains one row of this data contains C1, C++, but this row contains C1, Python. This is inconsistent. So all the things, all the updates must be reflect in every column, in every record. So then this type of problem or this type of challenge is normally we call it as an update anomaly. Once again, if one copy of such repeated data is updated, like this one copy of repeated data is updated, an inconsistency is created. See, I only changed this one copy, but so many other copies are there. So it leads to the inconsistency until unless I updated all the records, duplicate records in this database. So that is the inner meaning. Need to update all redundant copies. If it is not done, then data is inconsistent. So I think you also understand here what is inconsistency. So now according to these anomalies, three anomalies, if your database of may contains, it leads to some problems. So we need to be eliminate, we need to be overcome these anomalies. Thank you.